and men are liars. Romans 3:4a says, God forbid, yea, let God be true, but every man a liar. I want to repeat that. God forbid, yea, let God be true, but every man a liar. Men are driven by what they see, and what they see gives rise to what they say and how they behave. Life is more than what we see and what we feel. Those who live on their emotions will always be disappointed and let down. We are not made to trust our human instincts. Instead, we are made to trust the presence, the will, the word, and the spirit of Almighty God. We are made to look to God for his leadership and guidance in our lives. When God speaks, he speaks out of the volume of his holiness and his ability to make things happen. Man reacts. God forecasts. Man cannot change, or God cannot change in the least bit. But man waffles. Man vacillates. Man changes his mind. Man needs to be recalibrated if he used that word. Bible says in James 1:17, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above and cometh down to the Father of lights, with whom is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. So in Numbers 13:1-2, God gave Moses this command. And the Bible says, and the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, we can stop right here in this passage and just preach one day about the same little clause. And the Lord spake. And the Lord spake. Can you look at someone and say, God is still speaking? Say it again, God is still speaking. God spake unto Moses, saying, send thou men that they may search the land of Canaan, which I give, pay attention to this word, which I give unto the children of Israel, of every tribe and of their father, or every tribe of their fathers, shall he send a man, every one a ruler among them. It is instructive that God made this statement based on a fact. God made this statement based on a fact. And the fact is that he had already given the land to the children of Israel. There are some things, beloved, that God has already spoken, and no one can change that. There are some things that God has your name on, and there is no devil, no demon, no enemy that can reverse what God has spoken over your life. Hallelujah. It is now only for them, the children of Israel, to follow instructions and then come into possession of the land. Their duty was specific. They were to search the land. They were to set out, or Moses were to set out spies to spy the land. In other words, they were given an opportunity by God to see what he had in store for them, even though he had already told Moses about it. This is important. Exodus 3:8 says, and I am come down, this is God, and I am come down to deliver them out of the hands of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of the land unto a good land, and a large land, or any land, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, unto the place of the Canaanites, the Hivites, or the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. This is awesome. This is awesome. You and I do not necessarily get this kind of opportunity from God. He simply tells us to take him at his word, and then he will do the rest. But in this case, God went a step further, and he showed them a glimpse of what they would get. Are you hearing me? He showed them a glimpse of what they would get. And it gets better. They were to return and report to the others, the entire tribe of Israel. Bishop Whitney. God said, I need leaders to be identified so that when you come back from your odyssey in the promised land, in the kingdom, I want you to be able to speak to the leaders. And by you speaking to the leaders will get a grasp of what I have in store for the people. And the leaders will lead the people on to victory. This is important. This is important. Hallelujah. And so, these men, they went, but something went terribly wrong. Let me say this, when God tells us something, we are to take Him at His word. And when He does not tell us anything, then we must put our faith in Him. In other words, there is never a reason on our part not to trust God. Hallelujah. There is never a reason. If He shows you a sign, praise God. If He does not show you a sign, praise God. I am holding on to God's unchanging hand. I am holding on to God because I know that God has my best interest at hand. The spies saw all. They're now in Canaan. They saw all that God intended for them to see. And then they applied human reasoning to the word of God. God spoke. They saw what God said, but they applied human reasoning. They were bold enough, admittedly, to admit that they saw what God said. And then they kicked in to their human rationalization, not listening to the word of God. The giants that they saw in Canaan were there before God. The enemy is come and the enemy is go. God remains. Hallelujah. Am I talking? Do I have a witness in this place? Hallelujah. Have you been there? Have you been there? Have you been there? When you saw the cross, when you saw the schemes, Bishop Whitney, but some of the other, you're just going to hold a God's word. Hallelujah. And you sunk your faith into this, and you determined in the name of Jesus Christ, for Christ I labor, and for Christ I die. I don't care what powers there come against you, even if you die in the service of the Lord, die in the dignity of a believer in Jesus Christ. I want to tell someone, stop being afraid of people who are putting you down, stop being afraid of people who are carrying your name in the middle, and stand on the promise that God is with you, and He's promised never to leave you, and never to forsake you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who gets angry with you? That's their business. Who sits behind your back? That's their business too. But on Christ, the Son of God, I stand all on the ground. It's sinking sand. Talk to me, demon. All on the ground. It's sinking sand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, I want to tell someone listening to me, when God speaks something into your life, He is not concerned about your enemy and what they think or how they will react. He speaks, and that's all that matters. Sometimes be afraid to give God praise for the blessing in our lives because we feel as if the circumstances may change. But let me tell you something. If God has blessed you, oh praise God, oh praise God. God does not give faulty blessings. Look at someone and say, God does not give faulty blessings. If you buy appliances, Brother Elvis, hallelujah. Sometimes when you follow the instructions and you put in the plug, when you turn on the device, there's a problem. God does not give 40 blessings. Whatever God gives is perfect. Can I speak to someone in this place today? And so many times when God blesses us, Captain Bentley, we try to show it because we feel as if things may change. to Jesus.
Listen.
Hallelujah. To begin with, the whole idea for the spies to go to Canaan mission fight originated in the people and not in Moses. This wasn't Moses' idea. This wasn't God's idea. The people. This is what they said. Moses in Deuteronomy 1:22. They said, Moses is telling them, and he came near unto me, you met me, and said, we will send men before us, and they shall search out the land, and bring us forth again, by what way we must go up, and into what cities we shall come. What was it God's doing? But you see, even when you do it the other way, God will realize. Come on, somebody. Those who may be plotting and scheming against you, when they go that way, God will bring it back this way. Help me, Holy Ghost. The next part will take your blessing and put it back. God will move them out of the way. You better be careful how you mess with God's people. You better be careful how you mess with the anointing on a person's life, because God knows how to keep the alignment going. Hallelujah. And if God needs to be with his people in this place, the children of Israel, God knows exactly how to do it. God does not need any help from the enemy. He is God all by himself. So God. Moses to give them instructions. He permitted this to happen, even though his will for them was to simply go and possess the land. I want to say this something right now. God has already given you clear instructions, and you're waiting for proof. So let us stop. Let us stop. And what you're waiting for? God has already said some things to you. You better do it. Stop being very silent. I preached a message online this morning. And it says, I'll get back to you later. I'll get back to me later. A professional man called me, put a voice note on my machine. It's incredible. He said, I want to thank you for having the courage.
New words.
I'm hastening. We see it in the book of Joshua.
Here's God.
Be strong.
Here's God again. Only be thou strong and very courageous.
And then as if to drill it down into him. Joshua 1 and 9 is good thing.
Here's God.
Have not I commanded thee?
It's reminding him of the first words of God.
Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of a little courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee.
If
church under the same God. He's looking, he's looking at the congregation. He is understanding that fear is about to grip the people. He's giving me now. And so, before John continues to destroy the faith of the people in God, what he says, let's go right now. I possess that. You got it? So some things before they can hatch and before they can destroy the body, we need to move quickly on it. Put it down fast. I'll say some people in this church, you're negative. I'm not attacking anyone. You're negative. You say things to create fear in the people of God. Stay by it. Be careful. Because you're breaking people down. You're causing people to listen to your sight and not to the word of God. Are you with me? It takes courage for you to stand in the congregation. I say, let's go right now. Let's go right now. Who will go back to the house to cook food? Who will go back to some that show this? Let's go now. Because I says now. Because if we keep listening to this stuff, it's gonna break us down. What am I saying? Let me stand. Let's just stand. There are some people. Do not let them say a word to you. Because when they have finished with you, Captain Benedy, all you can see is defeat. There's some things that come to you on social media, hit delete. There's some people who are calling you, and when they call you, you can feel the devil in what they're about to say. Shut them down. Boom. No actually, shut them down, because we need to be on God's side. You can't be on the side of the doubters. You can't be on the side of the fearful and the hopeless and the fear-mongering people. You have to be on God's side. I'm not going to finish this. Come back and say that time. What are you doing? I want you, if you need a message, to ask you to recommit to hearing the word of God. Hearing the word of God. You're going to be okay by the grace of God. We don't need a new government to help us. We don't need the same government to help us. We need Jesus. So some of these speeches you really need to listen to. Fill your head with fear and doubt. Hatred and bitterness, anger, need to trust in the Lord. Pray for me, commitment. Lord, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord God, for this. We thank you, O God, and we bless the name today, and we pray.
Now shall we all stand and sing, praise God for whom?